Hello everyone, my name is Mian-Dan Yeo, and today I would like to present my presentation slides with the titles Synthesis of Anatase Rutile Mixed Phase Titanium Dioxide Photoanode for the dye sensitized solar cells. In light of the growing demand of energy, depletion of the fossil resources, as well as the global warming and associated climate change due to the combustion of fossil fuels, the scientific community has reckoned the development of renewable energy as one of the important tasks to be addressed by the mankind. Among all the renewable energies, solar energy is particularly attractive due to its cleanness and abundance. The dye sensitized solar cells, or DSSC, is one of the third generation solar cells or emerging type of photovoltaic technologies that was first developed by Michael Grazel and Brian O'Regan in 1991. DSSC have attracted immense research interest since its inception in 1991. Due to its various attractive features such as low production cost, bulk fabrication process, ability to operate in low light condition, as well as semi-transparent. Next, I will discuss briefly about the operating principles of DSSC. Upon illuminations and photon absorption, the dye molecules will be photo-excited from its electronic ground state to the excited states. The photoexcited dye molecules will then inject the electron into the conduction band of the semiconducting metal oxide, typically the titanium dioxide layers. The electron will then diffuse across the TiO2 layer into the tissue substrates, such as the FTO glass, to the external load, before falling back to the counter electrode. Concurrently, the oxidized dye molecule will be reduced by the reduced copper presence in the electrolyte, which completes the whole cycle. Heliothermal method is the most widely adopted technique for the synthesis of titanium dioxide photoanode. Nevertheless, the reported processing steps for the heliothermal synthesis of titanium dioxide photoanode were intricate and thus complicated the overall DSSC processing. In this work, we have developed a pre-invented methodology for the heliothermal synthesis of anatase rutile mixed phase titanium dioxide photoanode by omitting several intermediate steps, which can simplify the whole DSSC processing significantly. So here is a conventional flowchart of the heliothermal synthesis of the titanium dioxide paste for the DSSC. So the left-hand side shows the methodology as reported in the literature, while the right-hand side shows the methodology as adopted in the current research. So we can see that the methodology as reported in the literature involves several additional steps, such as the redispersion, colloid concentrations, solidifications, and also the paste homogenizations, which requires the use of specific instruments such as the sonicator, the rotary evaporator, centrifuge, and also the trireo mills, which complicate the whole DSSC processing. In the current research, it was discovered that the titanium dioxide paste can be obtained simply by heating the resultant mixture after the hydrothermal treatment, which can simplify the whole DSSC processing significantly. And by using this reinvented and simplified methodology, the DSSC with promising photovoltaic performance was fabricated, which will be discussed in the following section. Yeah, as I mentioned in the previous slides, the titanium paste was fabricated by using the heliothermal method. First, the acetic acid was added to the titanium isopropoxide, followed by stirring at room temperature. The mixture was then dropped into the deionized water, followed by stirring to complete the hydrolysis reactions. Next, the nitric acid was added into the mixture, and the solution temperature was increased to 80 degrees Celsius in 40 minutes, and held constant for 80 minutes under stirring. The resulting mixture was then kept in an autoclave and heated at 200 degrees Celsius for 9 hours. And following this, nitric acid was added to the colloidal solution, followed by stirring for 15 minutes. And lastly, the colloidal solution was heated at 65 degrees Celsius for 90 minutes to obtain the titanium dioxide paste. After the synthesis of the titanium dioxide paste, it was integrated into the DSSC to characterize its photovoltaic performance. So first, the FTO substrates were ultrasonically cleaned in the acetone and the isopropanol. Two FTO substrates are needed to fabricate a single DSSC, one as a working electrode and the other one as a cathode electrode. For the fabrications of the working electrode, The sensitized titanium dioxide paste was applied onto the FTO substrate by using the dollar black technique, followed by sintering at 450 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. After that, the coated substrate was immersed in the N719 dye solutions for overnight. The coated etra was fabricated by applying the platinum paste onto the FTO substrate by using a similar dotted black technique, followed by sintering at 450 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. After that, both substrates were sandwiched together by using a binder clip, followed by the injection of the electrolyte. So next, I will discuss about the characterization results and its discussion. For convenience, the DSSC based on the 9-hour heterothermally synthesized titanium dioxide photoanodes were abbreviated as HD9, while the DSSC based on the commercial paste was denoted as reference, or REF. From the field emission scanning electron microscopy or FPSDM image, formation of rod-shaped particles can be distinguished in the first figure shown here, which can be attributed to the high rutile content of the HD9. In the second figure, the accumulation of the spherical anatase titanium dioxide nanoparticles can be observed, and no rod-shaped particle was visible due to the absence of rutile phase in the reference. In order to determine the phase compositions of the titanium dioxide photoanodes, the X-ray diffractions or SRD characterizations was performed, and the corresponding diffraction pattern was plotted in the figure 2. So in HD9, the peak density of the rutile 110 plane was relatively higher than the anatase 101 plane, which indicated that the HD9 was predominantly comprised of the rutile phase. In the reference, no rutile phase was present, whereas the high diffraction peak can be observed at anatase 101, which indicated that the reference consists of pure anatase nanoparticles with high crystallinity. The ultraviolet visible or UVB spectroscopy was also performed to investigate the optical properties of the titanium dioxide photoanodes. As shown in this figure 3, the absorbance of the reference was higher than the HD9, and both samples exhibited absorptions at below 400 nanometers, which can be ascribed to the band-to-band electron transitions in the titanium dioxide nanocrystals. The figure 4 shows the photocurrent voltage curves of the DSSC based on the fabricated titanium dioxide photoanodes, and the corresponding photovoltaic data was listed in the table below. So from the IV measurement, the short circuit current density of the DSSC based on HD9 was around 90% lower than the reference, which led to a lower power conversion efficiency at 3.3% compared with the reference cells, which is 3.81%. The reduction in photocurrent can be attributed to the high rutile content of the HD9, which resulted in the decreased surface area. The high surface area of the titanium dioxide is essential for the efficient dye absorption, and hence the reduction in the titanium dioxide surface area will result in a lower photocurrent due to poor dye absorption. In conclusion, by using the reinvented and the simplified protocol for the flow-gel heterothermal synthesis, the anatase rutile mixed phase titanium dioxide photoanodes were successfully replicated and integrated into the DSSC. The power conversion efficiencies of the DSSC based on the anatase rutile mixed phase titanium dioxide photoanode was comparable to the DSSC based on the commercial paste, which demonstrated the applicability of the new methodology for the synthesis of titanium dioxide photoanode. Further investigations into the optimum heterothermal synthesis parameters, such as the heterothermal duration and the heterothermal temperature, was required to achieve the optimized photovoltaic performance of the DSSC. We would like to acknowledge MEVIL GRI Scholarship and the Telecom Malaysia Research and Development, TMIND, for providing financial sponsorship to facilitate this research project under TMIND Research Fund 2017. Yeah, and that's all from me. Thank you very much for your attention.